Hi, welcome back to the Positive Prepper. I hope that y'all had a blessed day. I want to talk, this is going to be a real quick video. I just want to talk really briefly about some things that would help you in a crisis situation. These are skills that you might want to strengthen because they can all help you survive in an SHTF event. So the first thing is knowing how to grow your own food, hunt, forage, can food, raise livestock like chickens and rabbits. Okay, getting to know how to use your natural land resources to survive is going to be really important. Know how to repurpose everything, right? In America, we tend to just throw everything out. After one use or when we just don't need it anymore. So things like coffee cans, peanut butter jars, empty toilet paper rolls, right? We tend to just throw that stuff in the garbage. However, for example, your coffee cans and your peanut butter jars can be used to store suckers or hard candies in for your prepping stash, right? Treats for the kids. Empty toilet paper rolls, fill those babies with lint or shredded paper. If you have an office with a shredder, throw some lint or shredded paper in there and you've got fire starters. Wrap them in wax paper, put them in your prepping preps, right? So just getting used to reusing. Try to find creative ways instead of throwing. And the reason that this is important is because during an SHTF event, you don't want to be stacking garbage outside, right? Because that lets people know, A, there's people living here, and wow, they're throwing out a lot of stuff. They have a lot of resources. So you're going to want to know how to repurpose as much as you possibly can, okay? Learn how to do a multitude of skills. So learn the basics about plumbing, electricity, car maintenance, construction. These types of things are going to come, could actually become very critical in an SHTF event. Not only does it help you with your own location, but you can trade those skills for other resources or services that you might need, right? Store shelves are trending to being more empty as this year goes on. So one thing that you can do right now is start stocking up on some of these outside supplies, if you will. Things like duct tape, nails, screws, okay, plumber's tape. Start getting ahead on these items because who knows how long those shelves are going to have this, right? So just kind of put that in the back of your mind also. Next, keep cash on hand. Don't rely on your debit or credit card. Start stashing away, even if it's $5. When you can, start stashing cash. And obviously, put it in hidden locations in your house. Don't forget where you put it. But start stashing that away because there may come a time when you're not going to be able to go get anything without just having that cash, you know, if the power grid goes down or whatever. So, being able to get some of those emergency resources is going to require that you have cash. And then lastly, learn to live simply. And it's kind of a weird thing, but try to learn to live without your utilities. So without the TV, without the phone, without the computer. You know, that's a really hard thing. And I struggle with that a lot myself because it's like, I want to know what's going on out there, right? I want to know what's going on with my friends and family. But I think the takeaway is just learn to live simply. So instead of going out and buying, stocking up on paper plates because it's a convenience, right? Wash the dishes. Instead of using the dishwasher, wash the dishes, these types of things. Start building up those skills and being comfortable just in little increments. I'm not saying give everything up right now. Just give them up in increments. What can you do without right now, right? The other area that that's going to help you is the fact that electricity and all of that stuff, the cost for that's going to go up. At least I believe that it is. And so learning how to cut these corners and live without the utilities, shutting the lights off if you're not in the room, unplugging your appliances when you are not using them, you hand washing dishes instead of dishwasher washing them. Just these little things are going to make a difference also in your electric bill. So I just wanted to do this real quick thing, just some things that you might want to consider kind of working on and building up these skills. God has given us all strengths with which we probably use on a daily basis. He also gives us the wisdom to learn new skills and how to apply those in different situations. So don't feel discouraged if you don't have all of these skills, or like me, if you're struggling with some of them. Everyone is in a different place. I don't care who you are. We're all in a different place with our abilities and skills. Just begin where you are and keep working at it, and you'll get where you want to be before you know it. Please hit that like and subscribe button. Hit the notification bell. Thanks for watching The Positive Prepper. God bless.